Find books your kids will want to read with engaging stories for kids, youth, and young adults, and nonfiction books to encourage and guide them on a purpose-driven life. The Wednesday Bookmark on CHRI.
Children's author Lexi Young Peck has a passion for deeply understanding how children develop and thrive in the world. Her storybook, What Do You Say to a Dragon? A story about facing fear and anxiety, helps kids express their emotions and use their imagination to face the scary monsters in their life. And it gives parents a healthy approach to helping their kids face their fears. So welcome, Lexi. Hi.
Hi, thank you so much for having me on.
So, Lexi, can you start by telling us, because I know you're a mom, what is the real life situation here that actually led you to write this book?
So, my daughter, Vivian, she's 6 years old. We had, about a year ago, a recurring nightmare that kept happening with her, and I had tried all of my tricks of what I knew to do as a mother, which is very helpful in some scenarios, the really nurturing, caretaking, and wanting to give her my bravery and say, it's okay because I'm here, and it wasn't working. So I asked my husband to give his insight, and I was kind of at a loss. It was many nights in a row. She could not sleep, and he came into the room, and I just watched him have a conversation with her where he changed the power dynamic from him giving her his courage and tapping into her own and saying that when she's afraid, there's actually a way for her to have power in the situation, even when it feels too scary. And so the conversation that happens in the book is what I watched my husband do with our daughter. And I realized not only how prevalent it was for her, but also how important it was for me when I stood up to something and I needed to look at it in the face, name it, and then find the courage within myself instead of trying to find it from another source.
That's good. Well, and you also don't, when you talk about how it benefited you too, you don't want to be having to be there in every scenario in your daughter's life as she grows up. You know, you can't have her only relying on you because she will be an adult in the world and will have to deal with situations herself. And actually in the book, you do mention, or the parents do mention, yes, when you're scared in real life, you know, you can call on mom and dad. We're going to be here to comfort you. But when it's in your dream, you can use your imagination. But it isn't just dreams, right? Like, what are some examples or scenarios where these same things will apply to kids in real life?
So there's every stage of development, even from the beginning of learning to walk, is a feat of courage and bravery for a baby. They've never done it before. They've never experienced it before. But the thing that kind of gets lost is that we go from a stage of expecting and fully encouraging that bravery. So, come on, you can do it. You can walk. Oh, they fell over. We'll get them back up. And encouraging it and cheering it on. And then as soon as it crosses the boundary of where we as parents feel comfortable, it's easy to sit them back down and say, okay, that was far enough. Your bravery can stop here, and I'm going to hold you in this spot until I'm ready for you to enter into the next phase. But the problem with that is that our kids are so ready, and they want to be curious. They want to learn. They want to do, everyone has heard, I do it myself. I do it myself, mommy, because they want to show what they're capable of. And it's an innate thing that's a part of who they are. And so partnering with that and saying, this is not comfortable for me as a parent, but I know that it's necessary and it is helpful. How can I be creative? How can I find strategies so that they feel that I trust that bravery within them, but I also feel safe enough to allow them to explore that and what that means. So for example, when you have a child who loves to crawl and on everything like a goat, I have one of those, and he wanted to be on top of things, and every time I turned around, it was like, what can I crawl up on? So one of the things for me was, okay, how can I find a way that I know that he's not going to fall and break his head open, but he feels like I'm allowing him space to get to the top of something that feels really high for him. And so finding those little areas within the development of our children, I think the younger, the better. And we tend to think that they're not as capable until they all of a sudden are 5 or 6, and then we expect them to know how to do these things. Instead of saying, all along, we've helped you get to this point where now you can do something that is more, that's higher up, that's scarier, that is takes more skill.
Wow.
And so I think that the younger we start, the less anxiety will build, because if we're expecting them to do something they've never tried before, or they don't have the skills or the experience to draw from, then it's really hard to ask them to do things that they don't have a prior knowledge of.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think that that is really key when we're helping our kids.
I find myself trying to find new words when I have a 19-month-old, and when he wants to climb up on the coffee table, which is not that high, I catch myself saying things like, nope, that's dangerous, or, and I'm like, I don't want to scare him. I don't want to say that. I want him to have that bravery. So it's hard as a parent to just make those adjustments and allow your child to do that. In fact, I saw one of your Instagram posts recently, Lexi, about your son, and you said something really beautiful about how, you know, it's scary as a parent to see this brave, daring child. But I don't know if you remember the post. Can you just share what you said in it about what your son can and will offer to the world if you allow him to be who he is?
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure which one, because I feel like with him, I've done quite a few of those ones, because it's just in his innate personality. I as a mother, had to get over the idea that my job was, of being a good mother, was to say, I'm going to keep my kids safe, I'm going to keep them where they don't have to experience pain, like the less scrapes on my child, that means that I'm doing my job right. Like all of those things that we kind of are told is how we should mother our kids. Mm. And I've had to come out of that mentality with him, because I don't want him to be suppressed in the physical nature of how he wants to get out into the world. Because if that is the way that I approach him, then he's going to look for it in other ways. Like he naturally, him and my husband, I've learned so much from the dynamic of just watching my husband parent our children. And there is such an important time to nurture and provide protection and do all those things. And that is something I love. I love the newborn stage for that reason. But it only lasts for a certain amount of time before you have to start letting go. And with Xander, I see him extending himself and creating a light in the people around him.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like the children I'm around that have a sense of responsibility and respect, because they have learned how to have a conversation with adults and how to experience what they have to offer, and can listen, but then also can be very adventurous and feel within themselves the power to step into something that feels scary. Those are the children that are going to create a pull for the kids that might be a little more nervous to come into adventure with them. And the world needs the kids who can adventure and stand on their own 2 feet and say, this seems scary, but I also have had the experience and the parents who have pushed me to step into something that's going to push me beyond my limits. And so I know that it's within me. And I've seen that with my son just naturally. My daughter is a little more nervous in mm-hmm. general, so we have to give her pushes in that direction, and we have to stand firm and saying, I know that you're afraid, but we are going to wait until you're ready, because this is something that's important. But with him, I just have to be, I have to let my husband do a lot of helping me know even how to embrace that side of him, because I do feel like I've been told to kind of suppress it, to hold it back. And I don't think that that is going to be helpful to him. So he is full of life that I can't even express. And I get excited when I see little kids like that who are allowed to go out into the world. And the physical wounds will heal. But if you have a heart that hasn't ever been able to express itself through bravery and courage and adventure especially, it's going to look for it somewhere else. And most of the time, it's not where we want.
Yeah. Wow. I mean, this has been so helpful. We're actually low on time, but I want to just quickly, you touched already on the steps and the tools, you know, what to do when you're facing that dragon. And I want you to just maybe summarize the book, the message in the book. What is this little boy being taught to do in his dream?
The little boy is taught to not hide behind someone else's bravery and courage, but to actually use your imagination that we all have. We're creative, every single one of us. We either learn how to use that creativity for something that is good or something that breeds fear and constant worry. And so the little boy is asked to change the worry into curiosity and to ask the dragon if the reason he's there is actually to hurt him or if the reason he's there is something deeper and something that he hasn't seen before. And the beauty of dreams and why I started there is that it's nothing that we as parents know our kids will actually be in danger, but we know that they can also explore something that feels scary to them. So standing up, holding your shoulders back, head held high, looking your fear in the face, and having the courage to ask a question and to be curious about and having the opportunity that it might be something that you didn't expect and what that would mean for you as you embrace being brave and embrace stepping into something that feels too big for you at the moment.
Wow, so good. Well, she has examples, of course, from her own kids, but also in her experience in studying childhood development. This book helps kids face their fears. It's called What Do You Say to a Dragon? A Story About Facing Fear and Anxiety by Lexi Young Peck. Lexi, thank you so much. I appreciate all your wisdom and your time today.
Thank you so much.
To hear this interview again or to discover more great books your kids will want to read, visit bookmark.chri.ca. The Wednesday Bookmark.